Hello again. You can watch a little bit of film of Bergen whilst I tell you what is on this film, Bon Voyage 6. As most of you know, this series supplements my A to Z of ocean liners and cruise ships. I keep getting more film in, which seems to be endless. This film is a real mixture. There are more than 50 ships shown, some of which are rather short clips, but others much longer. Those of you who love the old liners will be pleased to see some wonderful old black and white film, which includes Aquitania, Berengaria, Olympic and the Queen Mary. Some of the film was shot in the Adriatic, and you can see a number of small Greek passenger ships. I was lucky enough to do a 10-day cruise aboard Voyager in October 2012, through the Bosphorus, down the Turkish coast, and back along the east coast of Greece. Whilst on the cruise, I was able to film several large and small cruise ships. I'm very grateful to Richard Clack and Mick Hymans, who collect and convert this film, which I then share with you. I do hope you enjoy this episode of Bon Voyage. We start with two sister ships, both seen here in dock. The first is the Achilles, moored ahead of her sister. They both plied the Adriatic and Mediterranean trade. Achilles was built by Ansaldo Leghorn in 1958. Then we come to her sister, Agamemnon, built by Tirreno in Italy in 1952. Now we have a complete change. The Aida Diva, seen tied up in Istanbul in October 2013. She was built by Meyer Werft in Germany. Very like many of her sisters. I walked along the pier in Istanbul taking these pictures. Later that evening, with the sun setting in the west, we watched Aida as she sailed on a Black Sea cruise. Or possibly she was heading down the Bosphorus into the Mediterranean. Oh, happy days, cruising in the sun. From the deck of another liner, we get a very quick glimpse of Royal Mail's Alcantara in the 1930s. The Aerion was built originally Canadian Pacific Railways as the Princess Adelaide. They sold her in 1949, and at one stage she was called the Angelica. Like all these small Greek ships, they have had several names. Apollon 2 was built by Harland and Wolff in 1952 as the Irish Coast. She went through several name changes before becoming Apollon 2. Our Lanza, launched in 1960 for Royal Mail, was sold to Shaw, Savile and Albion in 1969 and became the Arawa. She was later sold on again in 1972 and renamed Hugh, a car transporter, after an extensive refit. We move on to the Artania, seen here in Istanbul, on my walk along the wharf. She started life in 1984 as the Royal Princess for Princess Lines, but was transferred to P&O and became the very popular cruise ship Artemis. In 2011, she was sold to Phoenix Saracen and became the Artania. As Artania, she carries mostly German cruise guests. We see the Oriole in Liverpool. She sailed for Elder Dempster on the West Africa run from Liverpool. These first shots were of her loading in 1940. They're in black and white. We move now to colour. Unfortunately, I don't have any shots of Oriole at sea, but these shots were taken on board as passengers relaxed around the ship. The last few frames are of the children's sports on deck. In 1974, Oriole arrived for the last time in Southampton and was sold to the Mariana Shipping and Trading Company, Panama. She was refitted and renamed Mariana. She was then used as an accommodation ship in Jeddah and other places, and finally taken to the breakers yard in 2001. Built by Brown on Clydebank, we see the 45,000-ton Aquitania in Southampton in black and white. She served as an auxiliary cruiser in 1914 and then as a troop ship until 1919. And she went back to trooping in 1939 before being returned to passenger service in 1948. We can see her here as she sails for the breakers yard. Always a sad occasion, particularly for such a well-loved ship as the Aquitania. A very quick shot of Union Castle's Balmoral Castle in Southampton. She also served as a troop ship during the First World War and returned to service in 1919, being retired in 1939. The Polish ship Battery, built by C.R. del Adriatico in 1936, proved after the war to be very popular, sailing out of Tilbury. She made her maiden voyage in 1936 from Gdynia to New York. 1939, she was refitted in Glasgow as a troop transport and not handed back until 1946. She made her first post-war voyage in 1947 and remained in service until 1969 and was scrapped in 1971. We now have some very good footage in black and white of the Berengaria, built originally as the Imperator by Volkan Hamburg. She was laid up in 1914 in New York. In 1919, she was taken over as a US Navy transport. In 1921, she was sold to Cunard and renamed Berengaria and sailed on the Southampton to New York route. We see her here as Her Majesty's destroyer Wrestler comes alongside. Soon you will see HM submarine L5 in Southampton water, which is to join the Wrestler and transfer the Sultan of Zanzibar to Berengaria. Apparently, the Sultan was nicknamed King of Lululand by the sailors. I don't think they'd get away with that in today's times of political correctness. Our final shots show the Berengaria in Southampton. I think the other ship is the Leviathan, also a war prize. We see the Cape Town Castle in Southampton, taken from a passing cruise ship. She was built by Harland and Wolff for Union Castle Line in 1938, but was taken up for trooping in 1939. She wasn't returned to service until 1946 and ended her life as a hotel ship. You will see here the Dilwara, a troop ship, and the Coronia together in Southampton. The Dilwara was built by Barclay Curl as a troop ship and operated by British India Line. In 1952, she was converted for passenger service. The Coronia, built by Brown on Clydebank for Cunard, was primarily used for cruising. Costa Voyager is the smallest of the Costa ships and has actually recently been sold. She was called Olympic Voyager, Voyager, and Grand Voyager before she became Costa Voyager. She's seen here tied up in Piraeus. The SS France was built by Chantiers de l'Atlantique for Compagnie Générale Transatlantique and started service on the North Atlantic route to New York in 1962. Although a beautiful ship, she was not a commercial success and was laid up in October 1974. She was later purchased by the Norwegian Cruise Line, NCL, in 1979 and given an extensive refit and modification for cruising. She was sold for scrap in 2006 and scrapped by 2008. During her service with CGT, she was also used for cruising, and we see her here leaving Le Havre on a cruise. The next set of pictures were taken as she left Southampton. We get a very good view of her hair as she backs out before turning and sailing down Southampton Water. The ship in the background is the Windsor Castle. At this stage, there were still a number of mothballed minesweepers laid up in Southampton Water. I couldn't resist putting the Hellas Liberty into this film. She's now in Piraeus, preserved as a museum. The next two ships, the Jadran and the Jugoslavia, are virtually identical. Jadran was 2,564 tons and is now a floating restaurant known as Captain John's Restaurant in Canada. We see her here first of all in Dubrovnik and then in Venice. Now her sister, Jugoslavia, which was built by Swan Hunter Wigram in 1956 and is still going. We get a good view of her here docked, first during the daylight and then in the evening. The 10,600 gross ton liner Jerusalem was built by Cameron Laird as the Bergenfjord. She served as a troop ship from 1940 to 1946 when she became Home Lines Argentina. In 1955 she was sold to the Israelis and renamed Jerusalem. We can join the passengers on a Mediterranean cruise. One of the waiters filmed on deck, and some of the crew at the stern of the ship. The ill-fated Laconia was built by Netherlands SB Amsterdam as the Johan van Oldenbarnevelt. She spent the war years in Willemstad. In 1946 she was returned to passenger service on the Amsterdam to Indonesia service. And then in 1951 she became an emigrant ship. In 1963 she was renamed Laconia for cruising, but caught fire in December of that year and sank. We get a quick glimpse of the Lindus, which was originally the Lyotte. When renamed Lindus, she was used for cruising in the Mediterranean and Aegean seas. Our first pictures of the Louis Aura were taken in Istanbul. This ship was built in 1968 by A.G. Wesser, Bremerhaven, as a starboard for NCL. In 1995, she was purchased by the Greek line Festival Cruises, and she sailed with them until 2004, after which she had a checkered history sailing around the world, including a period in Dubai, cruising the Med, in the Caribbean. She was used to evacuate US citizens from Lebanon in 2006. And then later she was sold to the Louis Cruise Line and renamed Orient Queen. Finally, she was renamed Louis Aura in 2013, which is when these pictures were taken. We now see her tied up in Piraeus. Well, here we have the Monte Anaga. She was built in 1959 in Bilbao, Spain, and was owned and run by the Aznar Line. She could take 163 passengers, which were split into two classes, first and tourist. She traded between the UK and the Canary Islands, or Spain and South America, depending on the time of the year, and she was a frequent visitor to the Thames. We join her here in some pretty rough weather. Nevertheless, the passengers seemed to be able to sit out and sun themselves on deck. To get to the sunny Canary Islands, one must first travel through the Bay of Biscay, notorious for its rough weather. Well, it seems to be pretty sunny, so why not sit out on deck, well wrapped up, rather than lying in the cabin reading The Cruel Sea. It's time now to go back to some rather calmer weather. MSC Opera was built in 2004, which is over 59,000 tons, and operates for MSC Crozier. We can watch her here on a Mediterranean cruise as she passes the P&O ship Adonia. The Neptune, here seen in Epitori Line's colours, was a cruise ship used in the Mediterranean. She was built in Denmark for Bergen Lines as the Meteor. Here we have the Northern Star, built by Vickers Armstrong in Southampton. The Shaw Savile Line. She was the younger sister of Shaw Savile's Southern Cross and a little larger. Originally built for the UK, Australia, New Zealand trade, she spent her latter years cruising. We can have a good look around her upper decks on a Mediterranean cruise. unlike the Southern Cross, Northern Star had a very short lifespan. Ocean Majesty is seen here in Istanbul in 2013. She's operated by Apex Tours. She was originally the Juan March in 1985, then the Sol Christiana in 86, Kypros Star in 89, Ocean Majesty in 94, Olympic in 94, Homeric in 95. We get a very quick shot of Ocean Monarch in Bermuda. She was built by Vickers Armstrong, Newcastle, in 1951. In 1967, she was sold and became the Varna. The older sister and almost identical to the ill-fated Titanic, the Olympic, built in 1910. By Harland and Wolff. She was modified in 1912 after that disaster, and in 1915 served as a troop transport. She returned to service in 1920, sailing between Southampton and New York. We have these wonderful pictures in black and white as she sails up Southampton Water. I was privileged to be serving in the Orcades in 1960 when the Oriana made her maiden visit to Sydney. We were just behind. I had the honour of blowing her siren on New Year's Eve 1961, just a day or two later. It seems ironic that one of my sons was working in Dalian, North China, when a typhoon put an end to Oriana's career. Harland and Wolff built the Orpheus. She was then named Munster in 1948. But from 1983 to 1996, Orpheus was chartered to Swan Hellenic and became a very popular cruise ship. Built by Harland and Wolff, the 28,500-ton Pendennis Castle served Union Castle until 1976, when she was renamed Ocean Queen. We get a lovely view of her here, berthed in Southampton, taken from a passing cruise ship. The Philippos, built in 1940 and not scrapped until 1971, was another one of those Greek ships trading around the Adriatic and Mediterranean. The Princendam started life as the Royal Viking Sun. In 1999 she became the Seabourn Sun, and in 2002 Princendam for Holland America Lines. She's seen here in the Bosporus. These pictures were taken from Voyager. In January 2014, she was due to have her engines replaced. The Romantica was built by Blythewood Shipbuilding in Glasgow as the Port Townsend. Then she sailed as Al Amir Saud until 1956, then Mansour till 1960, until ending her life as a Greek-flagged Romantica. Docked in Piraeus, we watched the Queen Elizabeth coming into berth, filming her so close it was very difficult to get her all in. But I moved the camera up and down so you would get a good view of the upper accommodation. She is the third ship of this name and was built by Fincantieri in Italy and is a signature class ship operated by Cunard. She's slightly larger than her running mate Queen Victoria and smaller than the Queen Mary II. As we left Piraeus on our way home, I was able to take these pictures from the coach taking us to the airport. The Queen Frederica, originally named Malalo and built in Philadelphia, she changed her name to Matsonia in 1937, and she was operated on the very popular San Francisco to Hawaii run. From 1942, she served as a U.S. naval transport. She was returned to service in 1946 and then sold to Home Lines in 1948. She was renamed Atlantic and operated on the Genoa to New York run, and then later on the Quebec to Southampton voyages. In 1965, she was sold to Chandra's and became the very popular Queen Frederica. We see her here on a Mediterranean cruise. was built by Vickers Armstrong. She originally had three funnels. She served as an armed merchant cruiser and a troop transport during the war. Here we see her in Hamilton, Bermuda. The Portuguese Santa Maria was built by Cockerell Harbuchen in 1953. She was seized in 1961 by rebels and finished up in Belize, where the passengers were released and the rebels taken into custody. We can watch her now as she prepares to leave from Lisbon, her home port. The Seabourn Pride is the oldest of Seabourn's six-star luxury cruise ships. She's 9,975 tons, and she's due to be replaced very shortly. She's seen here in the port of Anatolia, Turkey, on an Aegean cruise. We can see her again at night as Voyager moves out to continue her cruise. Built in 1955, the Southern Cross seemed to go on forever, ending her life as the Ocean Breeze in 2003. The Staten Dam also had a very long life. Built in 1956 and not finishing her life until 2004. She was built by Wilton Feyenoord for Holland America Line Rotterdam. From 1966, she was used almost exclusively for cruising, and in 1973 registered at Willemstad under the ownership of N.V. Staten Dam, cruising from U.S. ports. And now we have some shots around the ship on one of her many cruises. If it wasn't warm enough, sunbathing on the outer decks, always go inside. Another way of keeping warm was to go out on deck and play one of the many deck games. Thank you. Our final shots show her tied up in the Mediterranean. I've taken the unusual step of showing these two ships together as they're moored one in front of the other. They were both used extensively for cruising in the Mediterranean and the Aegean. Built by Harland and Wolff in 1936 for Union Castle, the Stirling Castle was used as a troop ship from 1940 to 1946 before returning to service and put on the Southampton to Cape Town route. The Thompson Celebration was originally built in 1984 as the Nordam for Holland America. In 1905, she was chartered to Thompson's. We can watch her here as she enters Madeira early one morning in the spring of 2014. The Celebration is the best part of 34,000 tons and she carries 1,374 passengers. The sun is rising as Thompson Celebration backs gradually into Madeira Harbour. Later in the day, we see her as the very popular Santa Maria leaves Madeira Harbour and Funchal for her afternoon cruise. The ship behind the Celebration is the Aida Stella. I think you will have gathered by now that a lot of the most recent film shown on this DVD was filmed from Voyager in 2013. It was on an Aegean cruise from Istanbul. Voyager was originally built as the Crown Monarch in 1990. Then she became the Nauticon, after that the Walrus, then the Jules Verne, and more recently the Alexander von Humboldt. In 2012, Voyager replaced the Discovery as all leisure cruisers ship. She's 15,396 tons and takes only 556 passengers. She's a well-designed ship with one slight fault, because in order to get to the forward observation lounge, you actually have to pass through the main show lounge. That apart, she has some very nice features if you like the smaller ships. We see her here anchored off Paphos. The last ship featured on this DVD is the 19,000-ton ship Windsor Castle, built for Union Castle by Holland and Wolfe. She served until she was sunk in 1943. Well, that's it for now, folks.